Ladies and gentlemen, dearest friends and respected guests, good evening and my warmest welcome to all of you to tonight's online cultural variety program and celebration of the 46th anniversary of the establishment of Philippine-China diplomatic relations and 20th Filipino-Chinese Friendship Day. 为庆祝非中建交46周年暨第20个非中友谊日，菲律宾共和国外交部。 中国驻菲律宾大使馆、非华各界联合会共同主办本次饰品大会及文艺演出，欢迎大家的到来。Tonight's event is hosted by the Department of Foreign Affairs of the Republic of the Philippines, the Chinese Embassy in the Philippines, and the Federation of Filipino-Chinese Association of the Philippines Foundation, Incorporated. And I will be your host for tonight. My name is Luella Chan. 我是今晚的主持人，来自非中电视台的庄琳琳。非中两国依依带水，隔海相望，传统友谊源远流长。非中两国血缘相亲，文缘相融，伙伴关系行稳致远。今天我们相聚在云端，共同庆祝。 中非友谊的累累硕果，共同欣赏中非文化的精彩篇章。Due to the COVID-19 pandemic, we have to bring our annual celebration to an online platform to ensure everyone's safety. However, we have a wonderful line of performances in store for all of you. So, without further ado, may we all rise for the National Anthem of the Republic of the Philippines and the People's Republic of China. 请全体肃立，奏《非中国歌》。 Please be seated. 请大家就坐. Today, we're very honored to receive a message from the Secretary of the Foreign Affairs of the Republic of the Philippines, Honorable Teodoro Loxin Jr. 现在我们非常荣幸地能够收到菲律宾共和国外交部部长陆新阁下的致辞，请收看.
On behalf of the Department of Foreign Affairs, I offer my heartfelt greetings and best wishes as we commemorate the 46th anniversary of the establishment of diplomatic relations between the Republic of the Philippines and the People's Republic of China, and the 20th anniversary of the Filipino-Chinese Friendship Day, with performances of Filipino and Chinese musical classics. This celebration gives us momentary relief from the extraordinary challenges of the present. More so because these performances demonstrate the harmony between our peoples. The Filipino-Chinese community is a reminder of the unbreakable ties between Filipinos and Chinese, and those of us like me who are both. My Chinese ancestors came here almost 300 years ago and stayed in unbroken line since then. We Filipinos represent the best of both worlds, the intrepid and pioneering spirit that sought opportunities in distant shores, married to the defiant native will that perseveres in adversity. So rarely in a relationship can you find one so effortless to keep as that between Filipinos and Chinese. It is not so effortless, however, between the two countries of China and the Philippines. To put it mildly, we have our highs and lows, and plenty of avoidable differences that serve no purpose on the part of either. But still, through it all, we come through. I am confident that the abiding trust and goodwill of our countries, nurtured through the years, will bear much fruit in the years ahead. As in the old days, when we broke through barriers one after another in language, culture, and beliefs, I have faith that we will once again overcome our differences. That faith has its deep foundations down to the bone of shared blood and life stories. Again, warmest felicitations and wishing everyone an enjoyable celebration.
Thank you so much to Secretary Debbie Loxin. 非常感谢外交部长陆新。Up next, we have a message by the chargé d'affaires of the Embassy of the People's Republic of China in the Philippines, Honorable Tan Qingsheng. 接下来有请中国驻菲律宾大使馆谭晴生临时代办致辞。
尊敬的非华各界联合会主席杨华红先生，尊敬的非华各界联合会名誉主席李荣群先生，各位侨胞、各位朋友、女士们、先生们，大家晚上好！很高兴同大家相聚云端，共同庆祝中非建交46周年，即第20个中非友谊日。首先，我谨代表中国驻菲律宾大使馆，向所有长期以来关心和支持中非友好事业的各界人士表示衷心感谢。感谢非华各界联合会为举办此次活动所做的努力。中非隔海相望，两国友谊源远流长，建交46年来，中非关系取得长足发展，各领域合作持续深化。特别是自2016年以来，习近平主席与杜特尔特总统保持密切战略沟通，为两国关系发展指明了方向。中国已成为菲律宾第一大贸易伙伴和第二大外国投资来源地，一带一路同大建特建计划深度对接，两国政府间重点合作项目稳步推进，合作与发展红利不断显现，为两国人民带来了实实在在的利益。女士们、先生们，当前新冠肺炎疫情仍在全球肆虐，面对疫情大潮，中非守望相助，始终如一。两国新时期伙伴关系在共同抗疫中进一步得到升华。在中国抗疫最艰难时刻，菲律宾政府和社会各界向中方提供了大量宝贵支持，中方对此铭记在心。在菲律宾疫情爆发后，中国投桃报李，尽己所能向菲提供支持和帮助。中国是第一个向菲派遣医疗专家组的国家，也是第一个向菲援助和出口疫苗的国家。中国克服国内需求巨大、供应紧张等困难，持续向菲提供疫苗，已成为菲最大最稳定的疫苗来源。疫情期间，在非中资企业 坚持生产，保障运营，继续为非发展提供助力。患难见真情，中国用实际行动诠释了什么是好朋友和真朋友。女士们、先生们，在这场抗疫斗争中，非华社会展现出了中华儿女情系双子、扶困济困扶危的无疆大爱。在中国抗疫初期，非华社会迅速行动，调动各方力量和资源，大力支援祖籍国，留下了许多感人的事迹。菲律宾疫情爆发后，非华社会踊跃支持政府和社会抗疫，并积极开展自助自救。在使馆的支持下，华社救灾基金抗疫委员会及时成立，团结华社抗疫，服务当地同胞，做了大量的工作。中国政府和驻非使馆也高度关注在非同胞生命安全，全力在非推进春苗行动，在国内疫苗资源极为紧缺的情况下，为确保女非侨胞能尽早获得疫苗，党中央和国务院特事特办批准向非出口一批疫苗，这些疫苗将于近期抵非。这充分体现了党和政府对广大在非侨胞们的关心和关爱，也再次体现了中方对中非友谊和抗疫合作的高度重视。女士们、先生们，下个月中国将迎来中国共产党百年华诞。一个世纪以来，中国共产党带领中国各族人民艰苦奋斗，创造了世所罕见的发展奇迹。特别是十八大以来，在以习近平同志为核心的党中央坚强领导下，中国各项事业取得历史性成就，中国已全面建成小康社会，正开启全面建设社会主义现代化国家的新征程。一花独放不是春，百花齐放春满园。中国的发展是世界的福音，中国将坚定不移地坚持对外开放政策，助力世界共同发展，支持全球团结抗疫，为推动构建人类命运共同体做出应有的贡献。中国的发展也将为菲律宾的发展带来重要机遇。只要双方坚持友好合作的大方向，继续保持战略沟通，妥善处理分歧，聚焦务实合作，我深信中非关系将迎来更加美好的明天。谢谢。
Thank you so much to Mr. 谭清生's message. 非常感谢谭清生参赞的致辞。Up next, let us invite the President of the Federation of Filipino Chinese Association of the Philippines Incorporated, Mr. Yang Huahong, for his message. 接下来有请非华各界联合会主席杨华宏先生致辞。
尊敬的菲律宾共和国外交部长陆新阁下，尊敬的中国驻菲大使馆谭清生代办，尊敬的各位社团领导、各位来宾、各位朋友，李世民先生们，大家晚上好。新逢菲中建交76周年纪念礼暨第20个菲中友谊日的到来，首先我谨代表非华各界联合会，向非中两国人民以及所有长期致力促进非中友好的各界领袖致上最诚挚的祝贺。今晚由菲律宾外交部、中国驻菲大使馆、非华各界联合会联合主办了这场别开生面又充满意义的线上欢庆会，期待大家相聚云端，共同回顾两国建交历程，评述非中合作成果，展望双边关系未来，同时也祈愿两国早日一扫疫情阴霾， 共创美好未来。中国和菲律宾一水相隔，比邻而居，两国人民的传统友谊源远流长。早在1000多年前，菲中两国就开始贸易往来。600多年前，苏禄国王带着菲律宾人民的美好愿望，踏上前往中国的友谊之路，在非洲友好史上留下了脍炙人口的佳话。100多年前，我们今天的许多华侨先辈从中国沿海远渡重洋来到菲律宾，同当地人民和睦相处，休戚共，结下了兄弟般的心和友情。回顾46年前，非中两国正式建交，标志着中国在南海地区多了一位守望相助的好朋友。菲律宾在发展振兴道路上也有了一位互利合作的好伙伴，两国关系就此翻开了新的篇章。46年来，在两国领导人的关心指引下，在政府民间的共同努力下，非中关系得到全面和长足的发展，政治互信不断深化，务实合作硕果累累，人文交流蓬勃发展，合作潜力不断释放。两国着力推进一带一路框架内和各项领域互利合作，积极对接，支持菲律宾政府推进大建特建战略。非中双边贸易额均突破600亿美元大关，中国跃居菲律宾第一大贸易伙伴、第一大进口来源地和第四大出口市场、第一大游客来源国。如今两国在经济、科技、教育、文化、艺术、媒体、智库、青年等各领域的交流合作气息烈弱，特别是面对新冠肺炎疫情冲击，非中双方守望相助，携手同行，一架架医疗物资包机，一批批新冠疫苗，承载着非中两国人民共同携手抗击疫情的友谊与信心，树立了人类共建健康命运共同体和健康丝绸之路的合作典范。非中友谊正历久弥新，焕发出新的时代光芒。20年前，在非华各界前辈领导及非中友好理事的积极推动下，菲律宾政府正式确立每年6月9日为非中友谊，不仅这一步巩固了非中两国千年的友谊，同时充分肯定非中友好发展为两国人民带来切实的利益。非华各界联合会作为菲律宾最有影响力的华人团体，同时也是非中关系发展见证者和推动者，我们长期以来始终致力于从事促进非中友好事业。20年来，每年都坚持主办非中友谊日的庆祝活动，积极承办两国政府及民间各层级交流活动，为非中关系发展做出了许多积极有益的贡献。未来我们将继续秉承创会宗旨，团结广大的非华人华侨，为促进菲律宾本地的经济发展和社会进步，为推动非中两国的睦邻友好发挥重要作用做出新的贡献。各位朋友，46年举行历史长河中的一瞬间，非中两国明明已经在过去的相互关系中创造了辉煌业绩，站在非中关系新起点上，让我们继续努力推动非中两国关系趋势发展，更好造福两国人民。 我深信非中传统友谊一定会结出新硕果，非中两国将永远做肝胆相照的好邻居、真朋友。祝愿非中友谊万里长情，人民幸福安康。谢谢大家。
非常感谢杨华宏主席热情洋溢的讲话。接下来有请非华各界联合会名誉主席李荣玄先生致辞。
Up next, we'd like to invite the Honorary Chairman of the Federation of Filipino Chinese Association of the Philippines Foundation Incorporated, Mr. Manny B, for his message.
请允许我用英文讲话。Honorable Teodoro Loxin Jr., Secretary of Foreign Affairs of the Republic of the Philippines. Honorable Tan Qingsheng, Chargé d'Affaires, Embassy of the People's Republic of China. Mr. Yang Huahong, President of the Federation of Filipino-Chinese Association of the Philippines.Esteemed guests from the Diplomatic Corps, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, welcome, welcome. This year's celebration of the 46th anniversary of Philippine-China diplomatic relations and the 20th years of Filipino-Chinese Friendship Day, we are showing to the worldthat despite of pandemic, friendly relations between China and Philippines are firm and solid. Chinese traders were already doing business with Philippine counterparts in the Philippines as early as 10 centuries. And the world's first Chinatown was established.In Manila in 1594. Since then, Filipino and Chinese are one close family, and we believe our solid and close friendship will continue for thousand years to come. Tonight,we have prepared and select some special Philippine and Chinese cultural musical numbers. Please relax and enjoy the show. Thank you. God bless. Salamat po. 谢谢大家。
Thank you so much, Mr. Manny. 非常感谢李荣玄先生。All right, so before we proceed to tonight's performances, we would like to request everyone to kindly open your computer, tablet, or mobile cameras so we can all take a group photo for souvenir. 在我们正式进入下个环节之前，我想借此机会请大家打开摄像头，让我们一起合影留念。好。请大家打开摄像头。All right, thank you so much. 非常感谢大家的配合。And now, let the performances begin. For our first number,Hailing all the way from the music town of Lubok in Bohol Province, we're very fortunate to have one of the most outstanding choirs in the Philippines today in tonight's program. The Lubok Children's Choir is composed of 30 members who became the national champion in the category of children's choirs during the national music competitions for young artists. 今晚第一个演出是来自菲律宾薄荷岛的罗伯克镇。曾获得全国儿童合唱团比赛冠军，让我们以最热烈的掌声欢迎 菲律宾罗伯克儿童合唱团为我们带来的合唱表演《命运与共》。Please give a round of applause to the angelic voices of the Lobok Children's Choir performing Harmony and Auspiciousness.
Hello! Grandpa said we should visit as often as relatives.
Mom said we should be good friends, hand in hand, help each other.
Thank you so much to the Angelic Lobok Children's Choir for sharing their talents with us. 非常感谢罗伯克儿童合唱团的表演。 Up next, we have a breathtaking performance of traditional Chinese music instruments, such as guqin, which is a plucked 7-string Chinese instrument performed by Wang Peng. And on the Chinese vertical flute called xiao, we have Liu Xiaogang. Paired with traditional incense ceremony performances in Tai Chi, let us all enjoy this rendition of Wild Geese Alighting on Sand. 中国传统音乐文化历史悠久，在漫长的历史中发展出一系列富有鲜明民族特色的乐器。接下来请欣赏由王鹏、刘小刚等人带来的曲器表演《平沙落叶》。 Thank you so much for that melodious performance of traditional Chinese musical instruments. Up next is a timeless Filipino folk dance medley composed of some of our most iconic dances, Subli at Kalatong, Maglalatik, and one of the oldest data dances in our history, the Tinikling. This performance is brought to you by the Filipino Chinese Theater Dance Company. 接下来是飞华舞蹈艺术团为我们带来的菲律宾民族舞蹈飞帽舞竹管舞椰壳舞竹竿舞请大家一起来欣赏。Please enjoy.
Thank you. Thank you.
非常感谢非华舞蹈艺术团为我们带来精彩的表演。Last but not the least, we have a percussion ensemble called Dragons Rising and Tigers Sleeping, composed by 李敏雄 and led by 王嘉南。接下来，请以最热烈的掌声欢迎李敏雄、王嘉南等人带来的歌乐合奏《龙腾虎跃》。 特别震撼的演奏。Thank you so much for that astounding performance. And that concludes tonight's cultural variety performance.
一路欢歌，一路笑语，激越的舞蹈澎湃着非中的友谊。愿非中文化交流的明天繁花盛开，光辉灿烂。朋友们，今晚的文艺晚会到此结束，感谢大家的到来。
Thank you for taking the time out of your busy schedules to attend tonight's celebration. Goodbye, stay safe, and wishing you all a pleasant evening. Mabuhay, 再见。